Welcome back to Novel Nomad, and this is going to be my first video in Tokyo, and in Japan, really. So we're starting off here in Shibuya, and I hope you enjoy the day by day. This is my latest anime obsession, Yuri on Ice, which is absolutely fantastic, and I had to get some merch while in Tokyo.
Yeah, here's Kate trying some gachapon for the first time.
We found
Yuri on Ice.
We did.
One, two, three, and then you twist. Mm-hmm. Keep twisting until you hear it come out. Push your hand in. There you go.
Who did I get?
Well done.
Oh, I got the Canadian guy.
Oh no, the worst one.
Yeah.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
All right.
That's three. Yeah.
Look, just push.
I'm pushing.
Look, it's not hard. Look. Oh.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Do I?
Keep doing it then.
I don't know if I'm gonna break it.
We can tell them it's broken. Because it just ate some of your money. This is a really depressing gachapon experience.
It is. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. It was another one and he broke the machine. Fucking John Jack. So we're gonna try one more time.
Once more into the breach.
Yeah, let's go.
I'll keep my last three in.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay, that one worked. Okay, finally.
Alright.
Moment of truth. Is it something different than Jean-Jacques, please?
It is!
Oh, thank God.
Oh my gosh. It is super cute. It's, Thailand.
Aww, sweet.
Peachy. Okay, I can do it, Peachy. He's really
good. Yeah, he's better than John Jack.
Your order will arrive shortly.
Was lucky enough to catch the very end of the full bloom cherry blossom season in Tokyo itself, and we enjoyed some delicious food in the Yoyogi Park, watching all the beautiful cherry blossoms just float past. It was just a magical morning. Transition from day to night, but be sure to watch out for my Shimuki Tozawa video, which will be coming up soon. Get to see what I did on day two.
Can you fit it all in?
No, that's why it's a video.
So after the neon extravaganza that is a robot restaurant, Shinjuku has two famous places on offer. There's Golden Guy and also Memory Lane, aka Piss Alley. Out of the two, I loved Piss Alley for the novelty of it, but Golden Guy is more known for its drinking, where Memory Lane or Piss Alley is known for food, but they are just such an amazing experience to experience at night. Character Street is home to all the famous little cute franchises in Japan, but of course I had to stop at the Pokemon shop and the Ghibli one, which you'll see in a moment.
This is cute. She's got little sakura.
Aww.
You're so cute. I actually really loved Abso.
Yeah.
I know I've been showing you a lot of amazing cherry blossoms around Tokyo, but I have to admit, if you are visiting Tokyo during the cherry blossom season, Meguro River with all the lanterns at nighttime is a must-see. It is really packed and crowded by the train station, but as you keep walking further and further along, the crowds thin out and you can truly enjoy this utterly beautiful experience. Okay, all I'm going to say now is look up Totti Candy Factory. It is so worth going to see and to taste and to experience in Tokyo. It is absolutely amazing. sweets, candy, and the colourful scenery that is Harajuku. There is a Yukio Ota Museum, which is actually for those amazing woodblock prints. It was absolutely beautiful and I recommend it highly. Sailor Moon fans, calling all Sailor Moon fans, did you know there is actually an entire store devoted to Sailor Moon? Yes, see it in Harajuku. This is probably one of the most crowded temples in Tokyo, but it does not matter. You have to see Sensoji Temple. It is absolutely amazing. I loved every moment. It is a huge complex, but if you don't get to see it during the day, don't worry. It is open at night as well, and it is illuminated. It looks amazing. The video of that is coming up a little bit later in the video. Whilst I didn't do much in the way of shopping in Akihabara, or otherwise known as Electric City, the arcades are awesome, especially this drumming game. We all had a go, it was so much fun, and we basically tried to work out the game as we went, but it was just so enjoyable to just go absolutely crazy and get in touch with our inner kid and enjoy some arcade games. So just like Chloe said, this is Cat Town, or Yannicka. There's not many stray cats here anymore. They've all been taken away to be protected by RSPCA. But if you are a cat lover, you can buy lots of cat goodies, treats, and other little souvenirs here as well. So definitely a place to see. Thank you. people, this is it. All you Pokemon fans who have been with the franchise for your entire life, or at least went until you're like five like me, this is the Pokemon Mega Center in Ikebukuro. It's in a shopping center called Sunshine City, and it has so much merchandise and amazing statues. It's so cool. We went there twice and I bought quite a lot of goodies, but definitely worth it if you do love or have loved Pokemon in your life. Transition, but this is me coming back to Tokyo. We were just in Kyoto and Takayama, and we drove through the mountains. Well, not we're on a bus through the mountains back to Tokyo to stay in Ikebukuro Bed and Book, which I will be putting on my Bookish Japan video. But we did visit some beautiful shrines in Ikebukuro on our way to the Ghibli Museum. The Ghibli Museum, and as you can see, Totoro is greeting us at the food ticket station. Tickets are really hard to get, so I recommend reading all the information that they put on the website about how to book, but no photos allowed inside because you get to enjoy the magic that is the Ghibli Museum. But I could take a little bit of video on the outside of the museum itself. the last stop in my Tokyo adventures. So thank you so much for joining me on this absolutely wonderful trip. Lots of Japan videos to come though. Be sure to watch out for them and hit subscribe if you want to keep watching. So I'll see you next time. Bye.